Thank you, Zahra, for your introducing me to this meeting, and thank for everybody that you join us and will listen what I try to say, to tell you about Gonur depe, about site in Turkmenistan. Of course, you know very much about Gonur depe. That's why I will not speak about it at all, because everything is clear, and I'll try to pay attention only to the some cemeteries, burials, and the funeral rites of Margiana. You know that this site was open in 1972 in the ancient Murghab River, among more than 200 sites. And later it was understood that not 200, but more than 500 sites are there. Gonur is the largest of them. And he gave a lot of different material, including very important series of burials. Here you can see, and sometimes maybe this map was published, this scheme was published, the general plan of Gonur depe and some places, some cemeteries which can we found there. The largest one is main necropolis, which was found in the beginning of 90s by Italian archaeologist Sandra Salvatori, and he excavated there first end of 90s. Professor Sarianidi joined these excavations and finished them in around 2001, 2002 years. And sometimes now we found new tombs there, because the sand is moving and open new places around this. Then when excavation of palace and around buildings continue, a lot of burials were found there. And here you can see very not exact, but very average data for all these places where the burials were found. In 2004 and in 2009, a very interesting complex of tombs was found in the southeast of the site, which was named as Royal Necropolis. Of course, we don't know where the royal or there were no what it this was a estate, but these tombs are belonging to aristocracy. It is clear because of very rich offerings which was found there. And later, excavating around the main place, we begin that this work in the second part of 2000, 2004, 2005, and we found very interesting complexes on the south west west from main part, which we named Area 12 and Area 16. And here is point small territory, which is the border between these two areas. And later I'll speak about specific traits of these areas, of these tombs we found there. Now we continue excavation just here on the north part of Area 12, thanks to the magnetometry, which was made by Swiss and German specialist from the Bern University. We know now we have a magnetometric map of this place and understand that a lot of tombs continue from this site, maybe far from the north. Some words about different territories of Gonur and some places where this about this territory I show you previously. Main necropolis found at main necropolis there were 2,800 100 funeral construction. Not only tombs, but different places about which I'll speak. Generally, it is dated from 2250 to 1600. We have not so much data, and now in the book, which was published by Rutledge, thanks to Dr. Bertil Leone, The World of Oxus Civilization, all data is collected there, not only from Gonur, but from all Margiana site and from many other sites from there, which are connected and which are belonging to Bactri-Margiana archaeological culture. This material from the main Gonur necropolis was published by Professor Serianidi, and partly some part of these tombs are presented in a book Margiana published in 2002, thanks to the efforts of Dr. Gabriele Rosiasmida. I told about tombs in the around the buildings, which were found during excavation of houses and complexes around the palace. We found there 1,936 funeral construction, and of course they are much later than main necropolis, but some of them are very early and can be dated by 2000. Again, later I'll say about some territories which are where burials were arranged earlier and then later. At the Royal Necropolis of Gonur, 109 funeral construction were found, but it is not all construction belong to the same period. I here show only the total number of burials there, but rarely only around 33 burials dated by 2300-2000 BC. And this complex was published by Victor Serianidi in the books, I think you know them. Unfortunately, full publication is now in process, and I hope that every year, I hope that this year it will be published, but it is not finished yet, and many question of, because very huge material we need to present there. As I told you, there is a special place on the west, southwest of Gonur depe. It is Area 16, and there were found 249 funeral construction, but here is a very short period of time because all these burials are under this large ash layer, which sometimes is thicker than 1 meter. Some tombs are on the top of this layer and some under them. And that's why we can say that these tombs are can be dated very short period. Close to Gonur depe during last years, we found two. No, there are a lot of these settlements, but we excavated only two, Gonur 20 and Gonur 21, where 100 funeral construction found. We previously thought that it is late settlements, but radiocarbon data showed that they dated by 2200, and later dates is 1500. And again, about a group on the west, Area 12, very interesting, and the investigation of it is now in progress. That's why I can show you only a few information about it. But many data show that it is very early, and it is not all tombs, of course, but we have dates from some of them, and they show that it is very early occupied. Totally, we have now information about 5,427 human and animal remains, their fragments, as well as pits and other installations without remains associated with burials at Gonur depe. And these human and animal remains were found in around 4,989 funeral construction. Among them, there are 326 cenotaphs, graves without human or animal remains, but with funeral offerings, and 275 empty ground pits, simple pits and pits with the burnt walls of different diameter. It is a very interesting element, because just on the area 12 about which I told you just now, it is show that some pits are arranged in some complexes in which there are no remains of humans or animals, but they are connected with some burials or are close to them. That's why it is very interesting complex, which again, I need to say that it is investigation of them are in progress, and now only few information I can show you. This is distribution of all funeral construction of Gonur depe. You see that the main part, half of the all construction are presented by shafts tomb. On the second place is a pits, about 130. And on the third place, it is cist and so name burnt pit and ovens, in which we also, in some of which we found animal and human remains. But here I calculate only ovens where human remains were found, of course, because it is an occasional situation and about which I also told you. Here is some very interesting construction, which we named ditches or large pit. It is a ground pit, but very deep and very large. Diameter of them are about 6 meters. And they were, first of all, we found them only at Royal Necropolis, but later in some other territories, but only 7 of them we know now. Only 2% of the total amount of the construction are burials in jars. And again, it is a special topic because we need to we found different types. Usually it is children and of different year, and later I'll show you them. Here it is shown so named fireplaces and the ritual pit. Ritual pit is only one. I think this is a segment of this circle. And it was found only once at the area in the Gonur 20, close to the men. Ritual pit differ from other types of here constructions because of it is a ground, small ground pit, and it was filled by burnt animal bones. As our archaeozoologist Robert Sataev said, he studied many such pits. In one pit, there can be bones from one or two, three sheep, which were burnt in the special place, and then only bones were put in this pit. Why I put it here? Because only one was found close to the burials, but the places where there were a lot of such ritual pit is a palace and a special room close to the so-named funeral part of buildings of funeral rituals in the Gonur palace. And close to them, there was a room, which many such pits, they were covered by ground, but Robert Sataev investigated all of them. But it is very interesting that one of them was found at Gonur 20, close to the burial. Some small information about shaft graves. Totally, we found 2,400 shaft graves. It is, as it was shown, about half of the total amount. And of course, they differ by the depth. They here you can see that not so deep. And they differ from different peculiarities of the tomb. For example, here you can see the different cover of the entrance to the shaft. Sometimes the bricks are standing with a small angle on the shaft. Sometimes the bricks are standing on the other special layer of the mud bricks, and sometimes not all the shaft was closed by bricks, but there is a special line of bricks standing on the step. A very interesting shaft grave we found just in 2019, and one more was found in the large necropolis and have number 1212. But about it, Professor Sarianidi did not wrote, and I found this only in archive of the necropolis, which are now we are trying to prepare for publication with full plans we have and photos and inventory. And this shaft tomb is at area 18. It is on the north east of the site, and it differs from other one with the bricks, which were made not only to close the entrance to the shaft, but all around the shaft, and the man was lying in this box, something like this in this tomb. Pit graves is 1,000 and a half, and also they are very different one from another. Very specific pit graves was named by Professor Sarianidi, burnt pit. Here you can see one example of it, where walls of this pit is very dark red burnt. On the bottom there is only ash or sand in different situation. And Gonur necropolis, we found about 200 of these burnt pits, but only in few of them there were human remains or animal remains. Sometimes there are only dog teeth or dog skeletons. Here it is shown that this man is sitting in very strange pose in the this pit, Professor Sarianidi and later anthropologist wrote that some remains of from this burnt pit belong to very ill people, and that gave foundation for scholar to said that maybe in the walls of these pits were burnt because to protect the pure ground from the very ill people. In later when the burials began to arrange at the palace territory, sometimes ovens and double ovens, which Professor Sarianidi named like ritual, used for burials. Only few of them were found. Here you can see one example where very ill man was found. Unfortunately, we cannot move bones from Turkmenistan, and we can only photos of them. That's why the real diagnosis we cannot make. But the dimensions of it, the dimensions of this human is show that he has very large problems with one part of his body. Sometimes it looks like tuberculosis, but it is not so. It is only the very unfortunately, we cannot make diagnosis here. Some pits, not so few, were found inside the walls. And here it is very typical example when the burial was made in the corner of a room. And we named them pits, but sometimes, and later you can see more of them, it is possible to say that when they organize this burial, they make a pit just along the wall, but make a small shaft inside this wall. That's why it is named by pit, but usually it is not a pit, but maybe something like a shaft. I told about ditches, about large pits, which were found at Gonur necropolis. It is also, this is also the one variant of ground pits. Here you can see a famous ditch number 3900, where seven people were buried. There was a four-wheel wagon, there was two camels, two donkey, seven dogs, and one dog was like a guard near the entrance to this room. Very interesting findings were inside this burial, and this was found close to, we named the previously we named the royal tombs like sepulchre, but when we translate text in English for the world of Oxus civilization, translator said that this is not a good word. That's why we now use the hypogeum. It is not, of course, a hypogeum, but it is close to the hypogeum number 3220, which gave very interesting material. And later I'll show you, I show you this plan because, of course, you know it very good. And this is a plan of this large ground pit. On the Royal Necropolis also was found a collective pit grave, ground pit, where was a woman, 30, 40 years old, and 9 children, age from 7 to 14 years old, buried. It is again one variant of the pits at Gonur depe, but only one is like this one, like this, when in the ground was so many people together. And I told once more about this Area 12. Here you can see the burial of a like a simple pit, and close to it again ground pit, but filled with fragments of pottery and a small amount of animal bones, not fragments of special funeral meal or something else. No, it is like trash, but it is close to many tombs. We found such pits at this part part of this graveyard. One more very interesting type of graves at Gonur are cysts. Have 261 cysts, and also they differ very much. Here you can see some types of them. This is a cyst where on the ground was lying a woman, and all funeral gifts are close on the other side, and it is important that here is a stone miniature column. Here is another type of cyst, which is like a room with niches. This is also not an entrance, but only niche. And here were buried two women, and not so many rich offerings were there. Only in one niche we found very small silver plate, small plate, and some pottery. But the dimensions of this cyst and show that this tomb belonged to some people who are not poor. And here is another variant of cysts on the top of the wall, not very deep, was organized a very simple cyst with only 2-3 layers of bricks, and all funeral gifts were put out of it on the front. And we did not found any walls around it. Maybe they were destroyed, but no traces of them were found there. On the area 19, it is on the north part of Gonur depe, out of the encircling wall around the main part. There were very interesting complex where only there we found also cyst. It is not an entrance again. It is destroying by robbers the wall of this cyst. There were three such cysts, and they were robbed by very much. But it is why I speak about that, because it is a very large. It is 6 meter long and 1 meter and a half deep. So it is a very, it is a construction is like cyst, but they are very large. Only in this place they were found. And close to this cyst, and usually in many other cases, on the south part of it, there is a special place, maybe square or something, it is ground pit, where sometimes staying vessels, sometimes are lying animals like here. It is a donkey and a pig here. And in other cases, there are dogs, there are sheep, in different cases, different animals. Here, one more variant of cysts, which show that sometimes the place where is lying a buried person, now it is a dog, are lying inside their special place, or on the place, or on the brick layer. Here, the dog was lying on the ground, but sometimes humans or animals are lying on the brick square. And not very poor offerings were in this. Also to this variant of tombs, belong cyst, you know very good there. It is cyst number 2900, which have very close parallels with Avaris burials in Egypt. And this is a cyst number 3210, where a main burial was a lamp. And this woman was lying on the ground, but the lamp was lying on the brick layer, and his neck was on the miniature column. And very rich offerings were here, from the silver, bronze, a lot of pottery, and beads were found here. And on the south again, there were some animals. It is a donkey, sheep, dog, and a small cow. Another type very close to cist are chamber graves. They differ from one from another because chamber graves have entrance. Cists are not have entrances. This is again known very good complex of three chamber, and one entrance. It is not a chamber but pit, ground pit in front of entrances to these chambers. Here are the some views of the inside of these burials of sheep in three chambers. There were sheep, ships, and the sheep which was in the middle has no head like it is seen here. This is a plan of this burial, and it was published in Russian, and the special large pit was made inside it, was where buried these walls, made brick walls, then made entrances, and only later was made this burial and this burial of a donkey, which has only one bronze vessel close to the head, and near its tail, there were three small lamps, very small, maybe newborn some days or week earlier. Also to chamber graves belong these examples. You know very good this lamp burial, which was published by Sarianidi many years ago, because, not because, but it was published. And this tomb also has two rooms. Again, there was buried a lamp, and this burial was later organized close to the corner of this chamber tomb. And here it is an example of one more chamber grave, where you can see the roof of it and entrance. It is, we found in this condition, not one, some of them, but the main part were destroyed by ground. This, just this tomb were not destroyed by robbers, it was destroyed by ground. And here I want to show you different type of roofs of cist and chambers because they were made in the same character. For example, here you can see the typical example of the roof when two bricks are standing on the angle one to another, and between them there is a brick. And another type is here. It is only one cist we found at Gonur depe, where the roof was made not from the standard bricks, but from the special, very narrow and very long bricks, which organized this roof. And this is not a robber's pit, but it is again destroying by ground during this 4,000 years roof. Here, it is not a good scene, but it is shown that inside this small chamber, there are two rooms. Between them, there is a wall, and the roof was made like here with two bricks. But here it is very important because we have only few, maybe one or two such cysts when the floor is covered by made brick also. It is not just it was robbed of the some pieces found here is here, but found in this tomb are here, but the floor is very unique. I told about burials in the jars. They have many variants which you can see here, and usually they were found in walls, not in the sometimes in the ground, sometimes in the ground on the floor, but sometimes like here on the in the floor or in out of the houses. But in some jars, there were very, very small, very young children, maybe newborn, less than 1 year. But sometimes there are some more elder children. But as show our anthropological investigation, they are not elder than 8 years. And again, it was shown that age of buried on the large necropolis and in the other territories differ very much. On the large necropolis, we have only less than 2% children, and all of them are elder than 8 years. So it shows that the rituals of when the people became to belong to the elders, they were made in 8 years. Here, three interesting examples of the burials in jars. This is the same burial, cyst grave 45-57, where the jars is put inside the cyst. There were no traces that this cyst was used previously. Maybe it was made earlier and then and was empty, and this jar with a young boy about 10-14 years is buried here. We did not make age and sex investigation because we hope that very soon we'll be at Gonur and finish this work, but unfortunately till nowadays this material is stored at the site in the our house, expedition house. Here is one more example where the child like this, the same age, was lying, and it is showing the typical example when the legs are inside the jar and the head is out of it. And here is another type of the, maybe not burial in jars, but when the jars are using for protecting of the body of the child. Again, this burial was made in the Kremlin wall, and as you know, Kremlin was excavated in the end of 90s, and so the walls were made bricks, and so they destroyed every year. And every season we found some burials inside these walls because it is not possible to see them. Previously, the walls were very good covered by clay in antiquity. And here was a child burial, and some large fragments of jar covered it on the top. I only show you because, of course, you read about this. It is a dachma, which Professor Sarianidi named this place. This is a dachma itself. It is a photo when it was found, and this material is published. And 10 people were buried here, and the last one was lying close to the entrance. And this is a complex of funeral rituals in the main part of Gonur Palace, and does not believe Professor Sarianidi that it was possible to organize something like real Zoroastrian dachma inside the palace where people lived. But this room is unique, and no one more was found at Gonur or in other in palace or in other places, buildings of Gonur depe. So no any funeral gifts they have. So maybe it is a real place where the people were put after their death. And of course, this idea idea is supporting by some fractional burials. There are six such graves at Gonur depe, three at the large necropolis and three in the other territories. And here you can see that the bones are collected and put in the small place. Together with this, I need to say about some words about Gonur Royal Necropolis. Many times, some of them are five times Robert Pitts. Robert entrances to the tomb. That's why of not every all time it is possible to say what people, how many people were buried there. Only some bones are lying on it, their places. But in tomb number 3200, first royal tomb we found in 2004, the situation was more clear. In one room, there were only few bones, but I can show you it is a small piece of bones. But they belong to different people, three of them to women and one for men, because very characteristic clavicula was there. So we can have an idea that some pygeum were used in the same way, that dead people were put there, and then after some time the bones that were taken out of it and put in the fractional burials in another place. But no connection with these bones with other one was not found, and no any fractional burials at Royal Necropolis we found also. So this question is again like a question. Some words about hypogea or sepulchres on the Royal Necropolis. I remember you about the tomb number 3220. Now it is in process of restoration. It is one of tombs where the stone disc was found on its own place. And just in this part, under this box for very, in Russian, it is a very good word, dara хранительница, a box for very rich offerings. But in English, we cannot find very good word for it, and try to use ascensories, like in churches. But in every one royal tomb, there were such boxes for, and more all of them, maybe not all, but main part of them, was covered with very beautiful mosaics, about which you know very good, because we spoke and show process of its their restoration. And just close to this place was found a very rich treasure of 25 silver, gold and silver and bronze vessels. And just close to it was found and this ditch number 3900. It is just here on this place of the it is again our first tomb, our first hypogeum we found in 2004, and you see it is not a wall. The wall is only this one. It is part of a large pit inside which was this tomb organized, like this one or that. Here is, you know, also this tomb very good. It is 3225 with eight rooms and very rich offerings also. Maybe you saw this picture, but I think it is important to show it here. There are some variants of hypogea on the royal necropolis. There are some hypogeums with only rooms, only houses, underground houses like this or that. Only one hypogeum is with an encircling wall on the ground. A house with four rooms is underground, but this wall is standing on the ground. And inside this wall, there were three ovens, one in P form and two rectangular, and with traces of fire, of course, both of them. This is the same tomb I show you just now. And close to it, you see there is a hypogeum ditch number 3900. And five of this hypogeum has one plan, a house and a yard in front of it. Houses are different by rooms. For example, in the first one, there were four rooms. In this one, where we found the main part of beautiful mosaics, you saw them. It is griffins with birds, with eagles. These are only one room, but some traces of walls can be here, but entrance was there. And Jigulia Taevna Muradova, who excavated this tomb, said that she cannot find here any walls between these two main walls. And these are tombs which were found later in 2009. And also they have the same plan, house and yard in front of it. And in this yard, there are some cells, different amount of people. For example, in this, we found about seven person, in some 19. And camels, dogs, and in this ditch close to the tomb 3235, there were also sheep and two dogs. And in these yards, there were four wheeled wagons, and also these wagons were in these ditches. In every one ditch was a wagon with bronze rims of the I think that because these houses has no yards like this one, and these ditches are very close to them, it is possible to suppose that these ditches belong to this hypogeum. It is a house for live, and this is a household, can be need four-wheel wagon, camels, and some serfs which were buried here are close to this building. But it is only idea, and Professor Sarianidi did not believe me, as he said that there is no real connection between these tombs and these pits. This is no any traces of walls, any traces of channels, any traces for anything between them. They look like separate tombs. But maybe later we will find some other ideas. Our excavation in 2012 show very interesting gave a very interesting material. Here you can see three stars and the number three. In all, this is complex of pits, ground pits with remains of dogs and some other animals, sometimes pig skulls, sometimes donkey skeleton. And it is very symbolic that all these groups of tombs are on one side of this royal necropolis. And out of them, we try to find any tombs. And many years, Professor Sarianidi asked us to look very carefully, but nothing was found, no any pit were found here. But very interesting thing is that the, on the north of this complex, there is a tomb of so named in Turkmenian Taychinakh. We hope that it was burial of horse, of young horse, but unfortunately or really, it is a tomb of donkey. And later I'll show you them. And on in this part, there were two interesting named by two interesting burial. It is a burial of cow and a burial of bull. So we can say that this complex of tombs have its own plan. This burial of animals underlines some ideas of the construction of burial ground. And here by four is shown a ground grave, I show you, with a woman, nine children and puppy. Only one collective burial, but it is again close to the, it is not here, it is there, but here it is ditch number 3900. I mistake to put for here. This was here, tomb of children and women. And here you can see this burials of animals from the territory of Royal Necropolis. A donkey burial, burial of fragmented cow, bull burials, and burial of seven dogs, which it is one of very interesting, which we found first on this east side of the Royal Necropolis. Now I want to show you some statistic again to underline the character of different territories of Gonur depe. If you know and you read the publication by Professor Serianidi that on the large Gonur necropolis, the main part, around 80%, is shaft tombs. On the second part, on the second place, are pits, about 8%. And the main, and then on the third one, it is burnt pit and ovens, but only one oven was found at large Gonur necropolis. And here you can see fireplaces. It is small burnt pit without anything, only for fire, for of using fire to make fire there during funeral or memorial ceremonies. But if we see the burials not on the large necropolis, but out of them, excluding Royal Necropolis, we can see that the main part, pits tombs, it is more than 80% of this such tombs here. And shaft tombs calculate only 70%, so very few. But the amount of cysts is very large. It is very interesting because some cysts are organized not very close to the wall, encircling wall, and sometimes very close to it. Only few of them is organized later and inside this wall, but previously it was made just out of it. So we can see very different type of distribution of different of types of burials. And but not all territories of out of large necropolis are the same. As I told you, area 12 and area 16, we show another proportion of this main type of tombs, graves. Here you can see that blue, it is pit tombs. And if we show the distribution of all areas except this three one, it is area 8 on the south of Gonur depe, area 12 here, and area 16 here. You can see that about 70% are pits. Only About 30% are shafts and cysts, and other are very small. And when at a large necropolis there were no jars, burials in jars, here we have about 7-8% of burials there. But if we see the these areas, we have another situation. Red, it is a shaft tombs, blue vein pits, and at area 12 there are a lot of shaft tombs, but if we see area 8 only few shaft tombs, but cysts are the large part of cysts are here on the area 8. I can add to this that some cysts were found on the north, and unfortunately here on the south out of, on the north out of the encircling wall there are a huge dump which composed the ground which was taken out of the palace during excavation, and Professor Sarianidi many forces used to move this dump, and that's thanks to this we can hear a place where can continue excavation now. But maybe here we can found more, because I show you area 19 where there were large cysts, very interesting funeral construction, were found just outside the encircling wall in this place. Maybe this damp is conserving very interesting information for us. What I want to show by this picture more, that it is here, you see that it is a large necropolis. Here is a small line of water. Previously, we thought that it was one part of Murghab River, but the geologist worked there and say that it is not artificial, it is not a real jar, it is maybe only some like pool, but not a real river. River maybe far from here, but some tombs here are organized just inside this water pool, and it is connected with with necropolis. So this part is very area 16 is very interesting, and by its dates we have very early dates here that show that maybe first tombs and first all complex of ritual animal ritual burial which I show you with three sheep and a horse was organized much earlier than other parts of burials at Gonur depe. And it was occupied very early, and very interesting is to continue working here and studying this information. And now we are looking, as I told you, here on the north part of area 12, which is connecting also with here with this area. Now only I try to say some words about funeral ritual, funeral rites, funeral rituals. The site of burial was indicated only in 2,200 cases, because many burials contains only destroyed only traces of skeletons. That's why it is not possible to to understand on which side is lying the buried person, any human and animals also. And here you can see, as it was written in describing the necropolis of Gonur, the main part, 70%, is on the right side. They are lying on the right side. Some of them, about 80%, on the left side. And on the third place, it is a supine position of them. Here it is show that one example, this is very strange abbreviature, it is head down, leg up. So the woman in this pit was put on the head, and her legs were on the upper part of the pit. Only one example on the large necropolis of Gonur. And here you can see the same parameter on the which side was buried the person. For the ruins, all territories except royal necropolis and the necropolis itself. Again, the main part is everywhere is on the right side. But the royal necropolis gave us different situation, but again, I need to say that it is not all only tombs which belong to aristocracy, because on this territory there are many tombs, about 60 from 100, which are made very late, and these tombs which of the small children of very poor people and only few are not destroyed. So we the information about Roman necropolis, you see on only 95 cases we can understand on which side, and mainly it is not hippogeum, because in hippogeum only only few person were lying on its in situ. And in ruins of you see on the necropolis, it is only about 10% of people who are lying on the left side, but on the ruins more than 20. So it is seen that the amount of the non-right position is going up. Here we have on fractional burial, we found only in ruins and in necropolis. On the royal necropolis, we did not found them. And here is one more position of the people. Again, it is only about 10, 13, as I remember. It is written as a hill. It is a very small children dead after birth. So they were put like a small round. It is very difficult to understand on which side that it they are. Maybe they were born dead and just the same time they were buried. So we write here that it is as a hill. Unfortunately, I can say only, I have no pictures now, but I can say that the same situation is on by the orientation of the head of the buried people. The main part, as it was written in a book about Gonur necropolis, about 70% is on the north and northwest. But the situation with the orientation of the heads on the in the ruins is differ, because different orientation is much often than on the large necropolis. And here it is some information about the type of burials. The main part you see here, percent 83% of the large necropolis is individual, and only 3.5 are double, less than 1%, and really it is only 21 graves are triple or more. For the same situation is on all areas of Gonur depe, including these two special area 12 and area 16, but only royal necropolis show also very different material, when only in ditches in large pits there were buried from 5 till 90 persons, also in hippogeum, there were buried not one person, but two, three, four. But it is many times I need to repeat that it is very difficult to differentiate who was buried in the main buried in this hippogeum, or who was served. When only when the people were in the yard, buried in the yard, it is possible to say that they were served, but when all bones are lying in different places of the tomb, and thanks to the robbers, it is very difficult to understand for whom these bones were belong. Only some words, because my time is over. I want to say about offerings which was put in the tombs. As you know, Professor Sarianidi wrote that it is possible to say that upper social strata buried their people in cist and shamba tombs, and it is about 5%. Of the buried in the necropolis. And lower social strata buried their people in pits, because there were no, sometimes there are no funeral gifts, and sometimes there are only one, two small vessels. And the middle class was buried in the shaft tombs. This is a general scheme of Professor Sarianidi idea. And here you can see, you know this picture, it is a contents of treasury from the tomb 3220, about which I told you many times, with the 20, which was robbed many, many times, but this treasury stay till our days, and gold vessels and 17 silver we found, including a very beautiful vessel with camels. And but the situation when I try to analyze the funeral gifts only in the large necropolis was not so simple. This small scheme show, and of course it need time to analyze the all things separately. It is shown that in shamba tombs we see a very different a lot of things and very large a lot of different things in one tomb, and here there is a percentage of the tombs in which these things were found. So it is possible to compare one type of tombs with another. And as I told sometimes earlier, that cysts show very different situation from other type of tombs. For example, pits are of course very poor. Shambas are very rich. Shafts are not so rich, and maybe it is show that it is calculate so because we have a lot of shafts, about 300, but we have only 35 shambas in the large necropolis. So this investigation I need to continue and to calculate and later this. But I think that cysts is a very interesting construction. Their differentiation, you saw some examples and different variants we have at Gonur depe, show that maybe it depends not only from the social but from other factors, and some people who were buried in shambas and in cysts differ one from another. For example, this high amount of the stone miniature column show specific trait of the people who were buried in cysts. In shambas we did not found any miniature column. Of course, here there is no information about royal and the necropolis and other territories of Gonur depe, but I think this is material for future thinking about this idea. And in the end, I want to show you this book, which accumulated thanks to the Bertillane for many information about Margiana, about Bactria Margiana archaeological culture and the surrounding areas. And it gave some information about Gonur also, but I say that thanks to that, it is possible to read many our ideas, which previously were written in Russian, now in this beautiful book. Thank you for your attention and excuse that it was so long.